Hello everyone, let's discuss the concept of magnetomotive force and magnetic reluctance. First, I would like to discuss the concept of magnetomotive force. Simply we call them, it is MMF, magnetomotive force. We all know that in electric circuits we have studied electromotive force, that is EMF. So EMF is responsible for the flow of current, but in this case of magnetic circuits, this MMF is responsible for the flow of or for getting magnetic flux. Current due to what? EMF, right? This is nothing but electromotive force. So like that, magnetic flux is due to what? MMF. Right? Simply we can say like this. So the force which is required to drive the magnetic flux in a magnetic circuit is called MMF. The force which is required to drive the magnetic flux in a magnetic circuit is called magnetomotive force. So that is the magnetic pressure which set up the magnetic flux in a magnetic circuit. Simply we can say we have to provide the magnetic pressure which set up the magnetic flux in a magnetic circuit is called magnetomotive force. And the units are nothing but ampere turns. Simply we can say AT, ampere turns. These are the units of magnetomotive force. So for the better understanding of magnetomotive force, I would like to consider a simple analysis. Let us say this is the conductor. This is the conductor material. So we have north and south pole. So this is the magnetic material which is conducting in nature. So obviously we all know that if a magnet is having two dipoles, obviously we are going to get the magnetic field lines, right? Obviously we are going to get the magnetic field lines these are the magnetic field lines clear. Then so this is the direction. Simply we can say from material to air like that inside the material. What is the direction? From material to air, so this is the combination. From material to air, we have to choose north to south direction, but inside the material you have to choose south to north. We will discuss in detail how we can choose this direction. We will discuss in detail while discussing the concept of machines. Okay, so here now I'm going to provide the number of turns. Let us so through that magnetic material we have provided some n number of turns. So through these turns obviously there is a current. Let us provide the current direction. Entering current is I and the leaving current is also I. So this is the current direction. We all know that by using right hand thumb rule we can get the flux direction. So the curl of the fingers represent the direction of currents. Obviously the thumb represents the direction of flux. That's why the flux direction is from S to N. This is the flux direction. This is the flux direction. Okay, right hand thumb rule. So curl of fingers represents and thumb represents. The curl of fingers represents what? Current direction. Like that the thumb represents flux direction. So this is the this blue color marker represents the current direction. Like that this is flux direction. This is flux, this is current. So we have n number of turns through that magnetic material. N number of turns through that magnetic, n turns. Okay, so obviously we have current through that magnetic material. So the strength of MMF is equivalent to the product of current around the turns and the number of turns into the coil. That is nothing but MMF. So if you consider any magnetic material with n number of turns, obviously if there is a current through the turns, obviously we are going to get the magnetomotive force. So you can write that point. The strength of MMF is equivalent to the product of current around the turns and number of turns into the coil. So simply MMF is nothing but what? MMF, which is equals to ampere turns. Ampere turns. Right, that's why the units are nothing but N into I is nothing but MMF, which is responsible to provide the flux. So because of this we have flux. This is about the main concept of MMF. So for this MMF we have some more definitions, other definitions of MMF. First, I would like to write first one. So, as per work law, as per work law, the MMF is defined as the work done in moving the unit magnetic mole, that is 1 Weber, the unit of flux, once around the magnetic circuits. Once around the magnetic circuit, which is nothing but the MMF is defined as the work done in moving the unit magnetic pole once around the magnetic circuit. This is first definition. Like that, second one, MMF is also known as magnetic potential, which is nothing but magnetic potential. So the current is due to EMF, that is nothing but electric potential. So like that, MMF is nothing but magnetic potential, which is responsible to provide the magnetic flux. So it is the property of a material to give rise to magnetic, it is the property of a material to give rise to the magnetic field. To give rise in the sense, maybe it should be flux, to give rise to the magnetic, we can say in terms of flux. Okay, this rise sense is nothing but flux in this scenario. Okay, next definition, the MMF is the product of The magnetic flux and the magnetic reluctance. So F should be equals to flux into S. S is the representation of magnetic flux. So these are the other definitions of MMF, and where phi is nothing but magnetic flux, S is nothing but reluctance. So these are the other definitions of magnetomotive force, which is nothing but to drive the magnetic flux we need magnetomotive force, like that to drive the current we need electromotive force. And simply the what are the units? Ampere turns. So the amount of current which is present in the turns, which is multiplied by the number of turns, is nothing but magnetomotive force. Now we would like to discuss the magnetic reluctance. Magnetic reluctance, you can say this is S. So coming to magnetic reluctance, we all know that resistance, right? In electric circuit we have resistance. What is the property of resistance? It has to oppose the flow of current. So in electric circuit we have resistance, like that in magnetic circuits we have reluctance. That is the only difference. So we can say first, it is the opposition offered by the magnetic field to set up the magnetic flux on it. It is the opposition offers by the magnetic field to set up the magnetic flux on it. That is, it is an obstruction offered by a magnetic circuit to the magnetic field. That is, the obstruction to the magnetic flux. So you all know that in electric circuit there is a resistance, similarly in magnetic circuit there is a reluctance. So let us consider electric circuit like that we have magnetic circuit. So in case of electric circuit, what we have? We have resistance. But in case of magnetic circuit, we have reluctance. That is the only difference. But in case of electric circuit, the resistance dissipates the energy, but the reluctance stores the magnetic energy. That is the difference. Dissipates the energy, stores the magnetic energy. That is the only difference, right? So, also in electric circuit, the electric field provides the least resistance part for the flow of current. But in this case of magnetic circuit or magnetic field, it has to provide least reluctance path. You can say this is first one. Let us say the electric field provides least resistance path for the flow of current. But in this case, sorry, this is first point. Here also provides least reluctance path. For what? For the magnetic flux. So it is denoted by S, right? So now I would like to explain in detail. Let us consider a magnetic core. Let us consider the magnetic core. For this, I am providing supply. Let us say, before that, I would like to provide some winding. So this is the winding for that core. Now I would like to provide the supply voltage. I would like to provide the supply voltage. Right, this is AC supply. First, we would like to consider a magnetic material or a core material. For that core, just provide the number of turns, or simply we can call it as a winding. For that winding, we have to provide an AC supply. So because of the supply, obviously there is a current, right? Because of the supply voltage, there is a current. Because of the, by using right hand thumb rule, there is a current in the winding, obviously we are going to get the flux. Obviously this is the current direction. By using right hand thumb rule, because of that right hand thumb rule, curl represents the current direction. So thumb represents what? Flux direction. So the flux should be this is the flux and the direction is like this. Okay, clear. Now this coil produces EMF, right? How we are getting that? Because of this, obviously we are having flux. So this coil produces MMF. So this magnetic circuit provides flux. Then what is the reluctance? This gap is there, no? This is reluctance of core. So from this, now we have clear idea about the reluctance. Simply reluctance, which is equals to length of the material or length of the conductor by permeability into area. So where mu, which is equals to permeability, which is equals to mu naught into mu r, and A is equals to area of cross section, and L is equals to length of the conductor. So from this, this reluctance S is directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to this area. Directly proportional to the length and inversely proportional to this area. So where mu is nothing but what? Permeability. So what is that permeability? Which is nothing but permeability, which is mu, which is nothing but the ability of a substance to conduct, the ability of a substance to conduct, so which in turn represents the conductivity of the material. So this mu naught is nothing but permeability of vacuum or air, which is equals to 4 pi into 10 power minus 7. The units are nothing but Henry per meter. These are the units, Henry per meter. Like that, mu r is nothing but relative permeability. For air, it is equals to 1 for air. Okay. So, mu is equals to finally mu naught into mu r, Henry per meter. So, this is the ability of a material to conduct. These are the, for better understanding, I would like to explain some observations. Observations in that, first we all know that the reluctance is proportional to length of the conductor, like that, which is inversely proportional to the area, right? And second observation is the reciprocal of reluctance is permeance, that is permeance, which is equals to reciprocal of reluctance. And third and very most important observation is reluctance is proportional to MMF, right? And reluctance is inversely proportional to the flux. We all know that MMF by flux is nothing but reluctance. That's why reluctance is directly proportional to MMF and inversely proportional to the flux. That is, if flux increases, what will happen is reluctance decreases. Right? If reluctance decreases, obviously the area should be increases. The area should be increases. This is very most important point. So that is, if air gap between the conductors, if air gap increases, what will happen? Reluctance decreases, right? If reluctance decreases, magnetic flux, if reluctance decreases, magnetic flux increases, right? That is the required quantity. So, in any case, we have to provide the least reluctance path. Therefore, we have to get more magnetic flux. That is, therefore, in most of the transformers, air gap is increased. Why? To reduce the reluctance, to avoid saturation. This is very most important point. So this is about the concept of magnetomotive force and the reluctance. Thank you.